Magnesium. We are just now starting to hear the importance of magnesium as an element that we are deficient in. Our life is now a lot more stressful, so more stress means magnesium depletion. The foods we are eating, whether they are processed, that they are very void and empty of micronutrients, including magnesium, or they are grown so fast, so artificially, that did not have enough time to absorb all the magnesium from the soil. The medications we're taking, the coffee we're drinking, the energy drinks we're drinking, the medication that could be diuretics, which lead to magnesium deficiency. So we know today magnesium is an essential element that mediates at least 1,800 different chemical reactions in the body that are essential for the well-being. And magnesium deficiency is extremely common. Even if the blood work level is at the borderline on the low side, that still means that we are profoundly magnesium deficient, as this blood test represents only 1% of the total body magnesium. So you ask me, doctor, do I have magnesium deficiency or not? My blood level is okay, but I'm going to mention to you what magnesium deficiency can lead to. Number one, it can lead to heart palpitation, atrial fibrillation, and some type of fatal ventricular rhythms can be reduced with magnesium. Magnesium is also essential for insulin resistance and all the chemical reactions that lead to consumption of energy and mobilization of fat into energy. It is a great drug for hypertension. It can reduce up to 5 to 10 points drop in the blood pressure, as well as smooth the blood pressure variations during the daytime. It is extremely essential for pain, as it reduces the amount of pain and makes somebody have more pain tolerance than before. Migraine headaches have been known to be partially related to magnesium deficiency. Last but not least, sleep is extremely essential for our health, and sleep patterns and what you hear the term REMs have been very well regulated with magnesium, and it gives the brain a good night's sleep. So what can we do to check if we're magnesium deficient? If you have those symptoms, certainly ask your doctor to check your magnesium blood level. And if your blood level is ranging between the lower number and the higher number, take supplements to get you to the higher number than the lower number, not to be toxic, but to be within the higher number, because that is the range where you should be. Before you take a pill, see if we can get organic foods, organic walnuts, avocados, any foods that are rich in magnesium, and you can find those on the internet. Take that, because a lot of your symptoms may be related to magnesium deficiency. With this, I hope I had an opportunity to shed some light on why we are definitely magnesium deficient and what are the symptoms of magnesium deficiency. And before you go to a pill, try to find the foods that are rich in magnesium. With this, I hope I made it easy. Stay healthy, stay safe, and have a good magnesium level. I'm Dr. Rafai, the virtual nephrologist.